Ah, what a beautiful day. So nice out today. Never been so nice out. Oh, who's at the door? Who could be at the.
Hello,
When did you move in?
sir! Mr. Hilton, well, Mr. moved right across the street, but Mr. Hilton sell you the nearest car!
Okay, I don't have
Would
a
you sir
car at
come
the
and
moment.
see?
Sure.
These are on sale!
Ooh, how much?
How much do you want them to be?
Free.
Free? That sounds amazing!
All right, I'll take both of them for free.
Okay, you have a nice day, sir.
Thank you
Misa,
for
have a
your.
great day, too. Paisa, paisa.
I will be taking this now. And Jar Jar was no more. All right, I'm gonna put these in my garage. Don't know what I'm gonna do with them, but they look useful. Ow, my tail is being chopped off. I'm gonna go take this other one too. That lizard fish thing was so nice. Lizard fish are always nice. Well, it's better than those ships I saw on Craigslist. They looked all red and Power Rangier. And the thing is, they were 0.5 cents. Don't want to buy them. I'd be getting ripped off. I wonder if Delta will get here anytime soon. How dare Jar Jar leave his garage open when he goes and kills himself? Why do I hear Jaws music? Mailbox, is that you? Yeah, so
Door's open.
I hope we get to go camping today.
Your door's open.
It is.
Oh, hi! Didn't see you there. I'm Bear Grylls. And welcome to another thrilling episode of Man vs. Wild, or in your case, Reptile vs. Wild.
I guess I was gonna go camping today. How did you know?
So, hello there, mister. I don't know your name. What's your name?
My name is Raptor Echo.
Hello there, Raptor Echo. I'm Bear Grylls.
Oh, I saw your show a few times.
Great! So we are off to the good start. Let's come on! I'm gonna teach you how to go camping like a supreme awesome guy would.
Let's use these things I just bought.
What are these?
There's something that the li nice fish guy sold me.
Oh, well, that seems intense.
They go on water.
So, first step, find where you're gonna go camping.
Take the other airboat and follow me. I know a spot.
Bear Grylls doesn't need boats. Bear Grylls can swim or walk.
All right then, follow me.
Bear Grylls. Bear Grylls. I'm Bear Grylls.
I think the camping spot is up here somewhere.
Da 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 da.
Ah, the weather's so nice today. The abyss is so lovely.
Da-da-da-da-da.
There's a gray abyss on the edge of our town. Don't ask why.
Bear Grylls.
Let's find that camping spot and not blow up this slightly old-looking ship I bought from that nice fish guy.
Hi! You seem to have found the camping spot.
Yes, I did.
So, now that we've found where we're camping, we have to decide a few things.
Like
First of all,
what?
the three things we need: food, shelter, and
Well,
water.
here's the food.
There's your food. So there's the first thing. Wait a minute. This is ammunition. This is not food.
Us raptors eat ammunition for breakfast.
You are disgusting. So, let's find, said Beggar Girls. So let's find some real food, shall we?
All
I'll go
right.
on a hunt for you, sir, because
All
you're very
right.
to this.
Where did he go?
Oh, hi, didn't see you there, random zombie. This zombie is perfectly capable of being eaten.
Oh.
But the first step is actually killing it. So, you gotta pull out your handy shotgun you brought with you, and bang! Bang! Now you have a perfect... Ooh, the head crop's still alive. Okay, so now you have a perfectly eatable baldy.
That's nice.
Come on, take a look at your new catch.
Wow.
He looks so edible.
Yeah, he does. Okay, I'm gonna bring some pieces of it with me. Was that a gunshot?
I'm shooting him to make sure he's dead.
He is dead, don't worry. I'm sure he is dead.
Just got to make sure, mate.
I'm just gonna tenderize the body with this hammer. There we go.
Okay, after shooting him 12 times in the chest, I have determined that he is dead.
Alright. I have a piece of him back at camp.
Good for you. So now that we have some food, we need some shelter. That boat right there, perfect shelter.
Okay, let me just make a good shelter out of it. There we go.
There's your shelter. Now the final thing you need water. Now we can try and find some water. But we must look hard, real hard.
One second, I am making walls to my little shelter. Walls made of rope, don't ask why.
You having fun there?
Yes, I am, with my rope wall. That is not physically possible, but we do not look at physically impossible here.
Come on, sir, we must find some water.
I know where there's some.
Where?
Follow me.
Tell Bear Grylls.
It's over here somewhere. I don't know where.
But you just said you knew where.
I was lying.
Oh.
Here's a road. That's not the wilderness.
That won't keep us hydrated.
Well, if you drink pavement, maybe you will be.
Huh, I've never tried that before. Maybe liquid cement works.
I found some water.
Wait right there, mate.
What?
Get out of that water.
Why?
Because Bear Grylls said so. So, you found water, but this is salt water. You're going to dehydrate if you drink this. So, we need to have another plan. All you have to do is get a filter.
Okay. Do you have one on you?
Of course not! I'm a survivalist! All I have is my trusty shotgun!
Okay, well, I guess this broom is gonna have to work.
That's a perfect filter! Simply move it and place it inside the water. It's floating. This is no longer salt water!
Now it's fresh water!
Drink it up!
Let me just fill up my trusty... Wait, that's a bathtub. Let me fill up my trusty pot. There we go, I got some water to cook with.
Now let's get back to our campsite.
Yes, we should. Let me just pick this up normally. There we go.
We are on our way to our campsite.
I hope Slendorman doesn't come get us.
Slendorman sounds like quite the individual.
He is. I assure you, he is. Now, where is that campsite?
You should know. You're the one who set it up.
I found our shelter.
You found the shelter?
Yes, I am putting the water over the fire now. That's not a fire. But don't ask questions.
Don't put the water over the fire. You need to save it for drinking.
But I did.
So now that we have shelter, food, and water, let's get a nice fire started.
That water is not spilling out because I made sure it wouldn't.
Now here's our fire, mate.
There we go.
One thing me and my generations did is we told scary stories around the campfire.
There's our fire god. Our fire will be out here, and we just roasted the water, okay?
Okay. So, want to hear a scary story?
Okay, let's sit on this log.
This is the story of Jankin Muglankin.
Ooh, I like this one.
This story takes place in a world just like ours, in a town just like this one.
Really?
There was once an old man named, you guessed it, Jankin Muglankin.
Oh,
and
my
basically,
God.
Mr. Jankin Muglankin, he would kidnap people and call them his pets.
He doesn't sound like a nice person.
He's not. One day he kidnapped some random person, and the fashion police tried to stop him.
Did they
but
succeed?
But the main weapon, hairspray, didn't have an effect on him.
Oh no.
So, the unicorn wizard came and stopped him with his seizure blast.
Oh, okay.
The scary part of the story was, his shoes didn't match.
How dare he?
I know, right? That's some horrible stuff. So, now that we've told a scary story, I believe it's time we thought of some more survival matters in the wild.
Well, I'm gonna secure the tent down with this hammer.
You are literally walking rope.
That's not a rope. That's a space station.
So, would you like to see our next survival manage thing?
What?
So, you're probably asking, what happens if you get shot in the stomach?
I have always wondered that.
So, now you've been shot in the stomach. Multiple times. Although, there's one more time. So now you have to try and survive with these many bullet wounds.
Well, I have a med kit on me. Maybe that'll
No, no, no! You are not allowed to use the med kit. No!
Okay, I stopped using it.
Good boy. So now you're bleeding from the chest area. What are you going to do to stop the bleeding?
I am going to get a bandage.
No. You're not.
Why not?
Because bandages aren't something you'd find in the wild.
I'll use a leaf and make it into a bandage then.
There you go. Now that's thinking like a true survivalist.
I ripped that one down. Now let's take the bandage off of it.
You're covering up the bullet wounds with a leaf. But what will you do to stop the bleeding and pain?
I will take some medicine.
Medicine's not in the wild!
Well, I'll take a plant then.
Good boy!
There, I'm eating some magic grass.
Magic grass, good for the health.
There, now I feel so much better.
The bullet wounds will remain for your whole life, but this would be an experience to remember.
Yes, it would.
So, now that you learned how to stop a bullet wound, and now you have food, shelter, and water, let's talk about nighttime.
All right.
At night, many scary monsters come at you, like in Minecraft.
Not sponsored.
So, you have to try and survive the night. So, let's demonstrate with one of the monsters you'll see at nighttime.
1 second. Gotta get some help. I am ready.
Now that you're ready, let's get one of the many monsters you'll see at nighttime. Poisonous zombies! Oh gosh, it's jumping at me! Oh, that thing is just nasty!
Oh god. Give me my better gun.
Now the poisonous zombie has multiple little head crabs that'll try and jump on your head.
I got my Desert Eagle. I'm gonna take it out.
Simply shoot at them and you will... Bad.
I killed it. Killed it.
But what about the main mother crab thingy monster?
I killed that too.
So that's one of the many monsters you'll see at the night time. Now, what would happen if you encounter a zombie torso?
I would shoot it. There, like that.
The head crab's still alive, though.
I sniped it while I was jumping. No, I didn't.
What are you going to do?
I killed it.
So, now let's try that without guns.
Okay, I'll use my bare fists.
Good! Use your bare fists, like Bear Grylls does.
Wait, I'm gonna use my machete.
Machetes, good things to bring in the wild.
No, I'm gonna use my Bowie knife.
Ooh, Bowie knives.
Okay.
What happens if you encounter a faster zombie terror zone? You shanked it! Make sure the head crab is dead.
It is.
Good job. Now there's one final monster that you will encounter.
Hey, this was Jacob McLankin. Why'd we kill him?
Trust me, that was not Jacob McLankin. It was his cousin, Bacon My Aiken.
Alright.
So, one final monster you will encounter.
What is it?
It is Princess Twilight.
Oh no! Yay!
You killed her fast.
Yes, I did.
Now you will survive. How do you feel?
Really good.
Oh, but wait! Look, your food now is full of bullets. What will you do now?
I'll get some more.
Good boy.
There, got some.
So now we've learned how to survive.
Now where's that fire? I gotta roast me some Twilight.
So, I was Bear Grylls. See you all next time on Man vs. Wild. I'll leave you two surviving the night, but all I'll right. be gone, though you will have a partner coming with you.
Alright.
I'll see you next time on Man vs. Wild.
Ow. I'm in the hospital. Okay, I'm just gonna fly back there. Okay, YouTube, let's pretend that didn't happen.
Jenkin McLankin's ghost is haunting you now, as well as Bear Grylls.
Bear Grylls is haunting me?
Yes.
Why?
Because you died with him.
Oh.
But you respawned and he did not.
Oh.
Maybe boo. I'm a ghost.
Why do I feel like there's someone here? Okay. Where's that fire? I swear there was a fire somewhere. Oh, here it is. It's not on fire anymore. Now let's get this and roast us some Twilight Princess. Welcome back to Cooking with Echo. You see, you gotta cook the Princess Twilight until they're nice and crisp. And then you must take the fire away. And then you gotta stop watching this show.
Are you trying to de-promote the Bear Grylls show?
No, I'm de-promoting the show I made.
My partner should be arriving soon. He's quite slow.
Is he a sloth? I've seen some of them before.
Wink, wink.
Yes. Oh god, it's not Jar Jar, is it?
No, of course not. He's not prepared for this type of stuff.
No.
Besides, he died at the start of the video. I mean, what's a video?
I got my harpoon ready. I'm ready to take on the zombies. Zombies, what? Where are you? Oh no, I encountered a Father Gregory.
He appears to be dead now.
He looked like a Bear Grylls, but he wasn't.
He also looked like some other person.
What's an Annabelle? He dropped one.
It's a weapon.
There, I got some seagull too. Some roast seagull.
You killed a seagull?
Yes, I feel really good about myself. Is your partner gonna be arriving anytime soon?
I don't know, he's slow as hell.
I'm turning on my air conditioning system. It's the fan on the back of that vehicle the fish man gave me. It also came with a weapon. A weapon. It's really cool. Come on, seagull, we're going camping.
My partner should be arriving shortly.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Okay. Let's cook some more fresh seagull. There's some fresh seagull. Right from the dead.
You are disgusting.
Well, we ate a zombie when you were with me, so I wouldn't be saying much.
It was a dead zombie. You just cooked a live seagull.
Yes, but it's dead now.
Good point.
You see, now we're gonna eat some Combine Elite.
I heard they are nutritious in the winter time.
Oh crap, he's shooting at me. He's reloaded. Now's the time.
Shooting, it's shot.
I don't look much at grammar.
Obviously just, not. You sound I'm like a lumberjack / redneck.
I'm just a redneck who likes to live in the woods. But I didn't know how to live in the woods until Bear Grylls told me.
Exactly.
Now I know how to conquer the wild.
And now Bear Grylls is a ghost, boogly woogly.
He's boogie woogie from...
No, we're not making references to Nightmare Before Christmas.
Although it is a great movie.
I will agree with that.
Boom. Headshot. I got the vehicle. I'm practicing my headshots. You sure your partner's gonna be arriving in the corner of the map anytime soon?
I'm sure of it.
Alright, if you're sure.
He's just gotta find his way around trees.
Use the V button. It's magic.
I just got a call on a cell phone. Yes, you are flying now.
He's flying Air Canada.
Oh God.
They have the best rates ever. He's flying Air Raptor because Raptors provide the best airways. Try Raptor Airways today. Not sponsored. Actually,
he has arrived. I'll talk to you later.
Alright, goodbye, Bear Grylls ghost. Who are you? Oh god, I saw you before, didn't I?
Camping, you are!
Yes, I was camping.
Now you're surviving!
Yes, with my bottle of ammunition in the ground. You actually
survived how long have you?
I have survived about a whole 5 hours.
Whaa!
I want to try cooked Yoda.
Ah, I'm on fire. Wait a minute, waiter.
I'm gonna cook my airboat that little fish man gave me.
Cooking your shelter, you are.
Shelter tastes good. So does Twilight. Twilight Princess tastes good too. Have you tried Rainbow Dash?
No.
It's delicious.
Bimbledash, I have not tasted. Mmm.
What do little green goblins like you eat?
We eat monsters and swap things. Mmm.
Okay.
We eat lots of ugly things, like these.
Watch out, there's something going after us. There we go. We got it.
That's it, I did.
We dealt with it.
Mm.
Oh god, there's a stalker. Got it. There we go. That stalker was gonna get us if we didn't move. Oh god, it was the Terminator. They're coming back to the future to get us. Wait, did I just make three references?
Camping, they want to come.
Just speaking out the video for a second. I just brokered the record of making three references in one sentence. Okay, back to the video. Ooh, my hammer is back here, my survival hammer. We're gonna eat crushed stalker tonight.
Delicious!
Oh no, we have to go hunting again, we ran out of food.
Zombies there are!
I'm sure there are.
Eee.
I found an applejack. Wait, what?
Zombies!
There's a head. There's a zombie torso out here. I'm gonna harpoon it. There we go.
Yeah,
I dealt with
die
it.
Zombies! Die! Die, zombies! Die, zombies!
I dealt with the zombie. Alright, we should be good now to eat and survive this night. And then I'm going back home because there's too many weird people out here.
Weird, I am not.
There's way too many weird people out here.
Weird, I am not.
Yes, you are, Yoda. You're just the weird green goblin person.
Not the super villain.
Not the super villain. I mean the green goblin. I'm gonna bring my boat back down.
Going? Where are you? Going? Where are you?
Somewhere. I think my boat is stuck.
Ropes are attached.
No, they're not. Where do you see ropes?
Underneath it.
I'm running over a Twilight Princess. Wait a second. Hold that thought. There. I think this is a good parking spot. Right on top of Twilight. Oh god, there's a rarity over here.
We need more oxygen.
Hey, do you happen to have a diamond tiara?
Hmm?
Do you have a diamond tiara that we could kill?
Hmm. Let me see. No, but we have Trixie.
Oh no, the great and powerful Trixie is... Get back here! Yay, we get to eat ugly hat tonight.
Dead she is!
There. I gotta use the MLG gun.
When you're the cops, it is terrifying.
Gotta stand back, I'm using the professional rifle.
From the end.
Thanks so loud. Sorry, YouTube. There, that's over. Sorry, we have to do that every episode, it's a tradition.
Indeed.
Let's head back to the garage.
Okay.
There, let's see, is that all the ropes? I think that is. There, I'm gonna go back to my house.
Wait.
No. Why should I wait? Why should I wait?
You know it for Yoda!
Why do you have a lightsaber? Why do you have the purple lightsaber. Isn't that the guy that killed Jango? Jango Fett?
Yoda, come for you with Mace Windu's lightsaber!
Wait, why do you have Mace Windu's lightsaber anyway?
Cause Yoda!
Okay, that makes more sense, I guess. I am going back to my house, and I'm going to sleep really peacefully in the house with no furniture. This boat is nice because it goes on water. The boat that goes on water. It's so shocking, I know.
Come back!
I'm in my house. Do not come and follow me. Please do not.
Yoda knows where you sleep.
That doesn't make me feel safe at all.
Where are you hiding?
I hear someone calling in my house. Gotta get the Star Wars gun.
Hiding? Where are you?
There, I killed Yoda. Ah, oh, that'll take a long time to clean up. That wall is disgusting. Well, I think we should end the video here.
Yes, I believe we should as well.
Yeah. Well, if you liked the video, leave a like. Don't forget, subscribe if you want to. If you're enjoying
subscribe to Freaky Bunnies.
If you're enjoying our content, subscribe if you want.
Indeed.
Don't forget to comment if you enjoyed. And see you in the next video, everybody. Goodbye.
See you scrubs later.